In this video, Jane, the wife of an acquired brain injury survivor, talks about how she copes with her husband's recovery.
Traumatic brain injury recovery.
Tell me a little about your experience of the recovery process.
I can say that probably for the first 3 years, I cried. I cried all the time. I finally found a spouse support group, which was so important and so different than any of the other support groups because, you know, everybody has a different role and spouses is much different than parent or child. They even told me I use more Kleenex than anyone they'd ever seen.
Hold the record.
I do. So I cried a lot. Mm-hmm. So it was really difficult. I can say, too, that I was seeing a neuropsychologist, and I tricked Don into going to see her because he was like, oh, I don't need to see her. So he goes in.
That's a guy thing, isn't it?
Well, and he goes in and sees her, and he comes out, and she goes, I don't need to see him again, Jane, but I do need to see you. But Don is what you see. I mean, he has a really positive attitude. He's really motivated. He's just what you see. So that was tremendous. And I'm a positive person too, but I think because I was more aware of everything that was going on, was he going to work? How was our finances? Yeah. All those worries.
Oh, sure.
Were, of course, on me and the grieving. Really a difficult process.
It was.
The counseling was really helpful because it would explain why Don was doing something related to his brain injury. I remember that specifically. I remember saying, how come he doesn't know to put milk on the cereal after he gets the milk and the cereal out of the cupboard? And she explained, well, because his brain injury is kind of up front and that's processing. And so that really helped. It helped tremendously. Mm-hmm.
She helped educate you about how the brain works.
And it helped me to say, well, he hasn't completely lost his mind. It's the brain injury.
He's not being oppositional. It's not intentional.
Yeah. So that was helpful. The other thing that was helpful is I made a point that because Don could walk, once a week we would do something fun. We'd go to the zoo. We'd go out to lunch. We'd do something fun every single week and get out of the house and have an activity because you can drown in all that's going on. The most important thing was I took a Tuesday morning art class. And at that class, I could be just Jane. I didn't have to talk about Don. I didn't have to answer questions about him. Or I could just go in there and be in my right brain, right part of the brain, and draw. And that was a real lifesaver.
That was very therapeutic. Well, what advice, Jane, do you have for survivors and for family members?
Don and I were lucky because I think he mentioned we'd been married 15 years at the time of his injury. And now we're going on 43. So we had a strong
Congratulations.
Thank you. We had a strong relationship. I know that was a real benefit for us. He also had long-term disability. So we weren't out on the street financially. Yes. So yes. That's huge. But mm-hmm. advice-wise, especially for caregivers, find something where you can still be yourself. It's hard to leave your spouse mm-hmm. or whoever it is for a while, but make that happen so that you don't lose your mind.
It's easy to run out of gas.
Yeah. You forget that there's another world out there mm-hmm. unless you go out and see it. Yeah. And things like yoga and exercise or walking in the neighborhood, all those things are just really good to clear your mind.
And what about advice for healthcare treaters?
Don was lucky because I'm a really good advocate. So when he would have a doctor, he had a neurologist come to the hospital and the doctor didn't look at him. He actually put his binder on Don's chest while he was talking to me. I mean, I know.
Really?
Really. So I went and protested immediately and we got a new doctor. So whenever somebody would not be respectful of Don or not be respectful of me, I would speak up. And I think that's really important. Being an advocate for yourself and your loved one is so important.
I couldn't agree more. Jane, anything else? Any closing remarks that you want to add?
So like Don said, going to those Brain Injury Foundation meetings once a month was helpful for both of us because, again, we realized we weren't alone. We realized we had it better off than some people, worse off than others, but it helps you find your community, which, like, I think most people live in a brain injury world. They knew nothing about it before it happened to them. Mm-hmm. So it goes back to that, educating yourself and meeting others in the same boat.
Please like, subscribe, and comment on this video.